Well, hello there and good day. Thank you so much for joining me. I am FrostPDP. I am accompanied by the wonderful Ariel, who's already pushing buttons on my keyboard. This is Baldur's Gate 3. This is Gale of Waterdeep, episode 78? I don't know, 78. We'll call it 78 for now, and if I'm wrong, you'll know in the episode title. Because you can read those things, right? So, we're Gale, we're all geared up. We got some more quests loaded up, and we're gonna pursue one of them now. I have no idea what Halston's gonna say, so let's find out.
You're here. Good. Now we can begin. Thaniel is trapped in the Shadowfell, but thanks to your efforts, I know where to look. Now I must go there. This opportunity has been 100 years in the making. It has to be me. And only me.
This cat has her head on my hand on the mouse.
Old druid's grandstanding. You have a part to play in this, and I trust you will play it well.
With the can't get my camera to
the I can infiltrate the Shadowfell, but doing so will sap my strength. I'll need your help if I'm to return. I need you to stay here. Keep the portal open until I return. And defend it at all costs. The shadows won't be banished without a fight. Once I open the portal, they'll swarm like carrion birds.
Guess we're starting off with a fight and then going into quest for returning.
You must not let that happen. Let's begin.
My love, you can't claw my arm like this. Come on.
Make passage for your vessel of light. It's ready. I'll return with Thaniel as soon as possible. Stay close to the portal. Buy me what time you can.
Cool, you drained his strength. What a useful strategy. I haven't gone over what we did when we leveled up. Mostly just straight level ups.
The hammer's gonna fall. Taste my fury.
To be honest, this encounter will probably be relatively simple. We have 6 people. Oh, the portal can actually take damage. That's ridiculous. Okay. See, if Starian's accuracy is up, I may have powered him up.
Thank you.
I got a feeling Gale is just breaking out Fireball. I'm kidding. Decision paralysis. There's so many one-hit point monsters on the field. This is also the second time I've seen this thing here. Did I just burn an offhand for nothing? I hate that. I can't disable it. Bonk. And like concentrating very hard. Wait, how the fuck?
Thank you.
Gale has a lightning bolt. It's gonna be a level 4 lightning bolt, I think. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Maybe eight. I mean, it's damage to our summon, but it's damage to them all, too. We're seriously doing this?
Thank you. something's wrong. Dreadfully wrong. No. It can't be. Yes. I'll bring him back to camp. He'll be safest with us. I need to examine him. I need to understand what's wrong. It's almost like something's missing from him. Come see us when you can.
We'll check the Shadow Vestiges in a minute. Lizella's 20 strength, by the way.
Come on, let's go.
My next ASI is going to be this. Notes. Need the Shadow Mastiff alive and intact. If that is not the case, the second half of your payments would forfeit upon your return to Baldur's Gate. I have generously paid a large amount of gold in advance and have supplied all the necessities you shall require to see this endeavor done correctly. They say you are unmatched for a poacher. For your sake, there's no desire. Okay, well, that clearly did not go well. Her love for it was like a plum. It's a porn. Her love for it was like a plum. It grew so sweet within her tum. and with a wiggle of her bum, she set right out to see love done. A curse had made the land its lair, it lay o'er all like willow hair. Oh, it could strip the body bare, so filled the people with despair. A shadow curse without a light, yet she would kindle romance bright, and in so moony dark of night, she went to it bereft of fright, and hugged the curse, the wicked blight. Her love for it was like a plum, then so sharply pain did come. It chewed her flesh like scrumptious gum. She trickled, she burst, she started to run. Thank you, Cat, for scrolling me way off where I was. Let's loot these shadow vestiges.
I applaud your taste.
You can almost feel the heat from the forge. This one was once a blacksmith. Desperate prayers to Saluna echoing from the past. They did not save him.
Please, I as well.
You glimpse a young harper on the eve of battle against Thorn long ago. He and his comrades toast each other in last line. Thoughts of baby names. She did not wish for her firstborn to be named after her mother-in-law. Mildred. Desperate prayers to Saluna echoing from the past. They did not save him. Faded memory of a boy and girl sharing their first kiss. Your own heart almost flutters in tune with theirs. You sense a fading echo of the person who once was, a dockhand. He did not ask for this.
Okay, I'm gonna go sell some stuff off and maybe contemplate an extra long rest or something like that, just because we burned through a lot of level 4 spell slots, but maybe not. Maybe we can just continue on. I can always Arcane Recovery 1. I want to thank you all so much for joining me. If you enjoyed this episode, please hit the like, share, subscribe, friend, follow, or whatever buttons. It really does help the channel grow. It lets me know what you're watching so I can keep making more of it. And I really do appreciate it from the very bottom of my heart. I'm on Twitch, Twitter, YouTube, Discord, all those good things. Links are in the description down below. Thank you all so much for joining me, as always, on the channel. Peace.